Interception up the field by McMaster's, and ball got down. Cavan won it, took a hit. Seen the runner, McEwan, you know, he controlled it, did all the hard stuff, in on the keeper, 1-1. Look at the onion bags, we can't be missing goals like that. You know, you're not going to get too many chances in a derby like this.
14 and a half minutes played here at Dara in the opening half. It's Leitrim who lead by 3-1, and Longford have just missed a goal chance. Back to you in studio.
Yes, indeed. Thank you very much, John. And speaking of goals, as we go back over to the game between Roscommon and Cavan, there has been a goal in that game, and it's gone to Roscommon. Cathal Craig has registered.
For Gilbride to run into, which he'll lap up all day. So possibly the answer is maybe put somebody back in front of him, because the full forward line, as we alluded to before the game, the forward line of Roscommon is amongst the best in the country, and Cavan need to curtail their scoring opportunities.
So Roscommon, one goal and 2 points. Cavan, 2 points. Here in Kiltoom on opening Sunday of the Allianz National Football League. 12 and a half minutes of play gone at the moment. So the ball walked across there. Nice play by the Cavanmen. Interlinked to play there. Cavan now have suddenly found a little bit of space, a little bit of freedom. They're going for a point. And it's out behind the goal and it's gone wide. It's another wide for the Cavanmen. 4 wides for Cavan and 1 wide for Roscommon. The one thing about Roscommon, Dorney, the last few weeks, 2 goals against Mayo, 4 against Galway, and now a goal in the first 12 minutes against Cavan. They're creating goal chances.
Certainly are. And they say goals are in matches. And they say take your points and the goals will come out. Roscommon just seem to be getting goals, and that's great to see that.
Sinan Kilbride, as Damien said, instrumental. It's going to be a good battle, Rory Dunn and Sinan Kilbride. But Cavan's response upon the Roscommon goal has been positive. Free taken very, very quickly. Comes across to the wing back. Can he curl this over the bar? No, he can't. 5 wides for Cavan. And we've hardly sneezed in the match, Damien. 15 minutes of play gone. And they've shot 5 wides.
They have indeed, yeah. We're just to say hello to the Shannon side listeners who are back in. There has been a goal and 2 points in the game since they were last with us. The goal coming from Cathal Craig after some great work by Sinan Kilbride. Roscommon point came from, was it a Kieran Morta? Kieran Morta, and then a point coming back after the goal by Martin Riley. So the current score is a goal and a point, or a goal and 2 points to Roscommon, 2 points to Cavan. The game brought to you by McManus Pharmacies, Cavan, Beltorbit, and Ballyconnell, the proud sponsors of the Cavan GAA on Shannonside Northern Sound.
Cavan on the attack. The Roscommon goal was absolutely, I suppose, like putting the cherry on top of the cake, and Sinan Kilbride got it, but Cathal Craig iced it, and was a great work by Kieran Murta. Terrific ball, Sinan Kilbride, who just got round Rory John and then laid it off to Cathal Craig, who couldn't miss from no more than 2 yards out. But Cavan have responded well, and they've got a free in for themselves there. That's Martin John, a tricky customer inside. So two great backers either into the field. You have Dunn versus Niall County, and you have Sinan Kilbride against Rory Dunn. So that certainly could have a big bearing on how this game pans out. But Kieran Murta with a point for Roscommon. Our Shannon side listeners are back with us 1-2-2. An opportunity for Cavan to get a point onto the board here. Great crowd, good atmosphere here, but absolutely wonderful afternoon. Wonderful sunshine for spectators. Certainly last night you weren't going to think that. As right now, Martin Dunn kicks it nicely and he has sliced it over the bar. It's his second score from a free, and that makes it now Roscommon a goal and 2 points. That's 5 points, 3 points for Cavan. And Dorney, from the Roscommon goal, Cavan have responded very well.
Well, certainly have, but Roscommon, if you look at them, Cavan actually have 5 wides. Roscommon have won. Roscommon are not winning the position around the middle of the field, and they have got to win it around there. If they don't win it around there, they're not going to win this match.
Ball broken out by Darren O'Malley, Michael Glavy's Jacob. Talking about Glavy's Jacob, we had a terrific night at the Audrey Hotel in June last night with the Michael Glavy's Good Folk Junior A Champions in 2014, and they put on a show last night in June. They certainly did. We had a terrific night. Delighted to be out of Divin and myself, and Michael Glavy's rolled out the red carpet, celebrating a wonderful year for the club, and a better club to celebrate in style. They know how to do things right. So well done to Michael Glavy's, and Darren O'Malley's in goal this afternoon, the Michael Glavy's man. He was a very early John Evans, don't worry. Ball worked across far side of the field. Nice hand by Kieran Cassidy to Carl Shine. Will they go route one? Kibroyd wants it. The two Murchers want it. They're gone route one. Into Kibroyd. Kibroyd has it again. A mistake by the Cavan fullback. Kibroyd selling more dummies than they find a mother care. Ball got across the far side of the field. Inside to Kieran Murta. And Murta scooped that high and wide. An opportunity there for Roscommon. Five wides to two. Damien, you mentioned at the Northern Sound coverage. Our shout-outs are listening now with us that Sinan Kibroyd is causing a lot of problems for Rory Judd, who is a good fullback.
He's a very good fullback. Like, it's funny because physique-wise, they're pretty much a mirror image of each other, but Sinan Kilbride's movement is so, so hard to mark. He doesn't just make one run in one direction. He changes direction three or four times, which is exactly what you want a full forward doing. And he's also so good when he's on the ball. He's not selfish. He looks around him, and it's hard to mark a man of that talent.
16 and a half minutes gone. Allianz National Football League Division 2 encounter. Huge division for Roscommon and Cavan, the two promotion teams. Roscommon have 3 scores, a goal and 2. Cavan have 3 scores, so 3 scores apiece. Cavan going in there.
So that's how we leave it just for this moment.
From the hands, kicks it right footed. In it goes from Cavan. That looks better from Cavan. It is better from Cavan. He's reduced the deficit 25 minutes and 42 seconds played here, Dara, in the opening half. 2 points between the teams. Leitrim leading 6-4. Back to you in studio.
Excellent stuff, John. Thank you so much for that one. So that's an action-packed game there we have as well. And Roscommon versus Cavan, we have missed another point in that game. I believe it's been a fantastic score by Jermaine Murta, which leaves it being right now Roscommon 1-3, Cavan 4 points is the score as we go across to the boys in Kiltoom.
At the moment, he's only covers the Connacht League, but right now at the moment, we cover the McKinnon Cup. I thought there was a foul in there. The Cavan player is gone to ground. I thought that was a stonewall free-in for Cavan, but anyway, we're in the up here in the commentary box. Mark Healy. He's competitive to boot for Roscommon. Now can Roscommon take advantage there, maybe of a free that could have been conceded to Mark Nelly, another Roscommon Gaelsman, across to Shawnee McDermott there. The ball has gone across. We welcome back our Shannon side listeners to us. It's 1-3 to 4 points. It was 1-2 to 3 the last time you joined us, Shannon side listeners. It's now 1-3-4. Roscommon with a wonderful point by Jermaine Murta. Cavan got 3 in a row. Martin Dunn, Martin Flanagan, and then the score, a great score by the cornerback. He got no nosebleed. Darren McVitie of Cavan. He came up and kicked over a wonderful point. 4 scores apiece. 25 minutes gone. It's tight. It's tense. It's tenacious. And at the moment here, the temperature is a little bit like being in a sauna. Last night it was -4, -5. +10, +12 is afternoon. The temperature stakes here. The promotion teams, the great rivals, the local derbies, the 40s for Roscommon and Cavan. And now Roscommon and Cavan are making their own piece of history. Their 4th meeting inside in a year. I want to mention Tommy Joe Carr, a great listener to Shannonside Northern Sound Radio. He's listening in Roscommon Town. That, of course, is Tommy Joe Carr from Listener Bulge. And also the Clannagale G Club, as I mentioned, next Saturday night. Huge night for Clannagale G Club. They are having their dinner dance. And special guests is a new senior football team manager, Paul Curran, former Dublin player, former Ballymun Kickers manager. He's a special guest for Clannagale. I think it's at Lord's Place Hotel next Saturday night. So, no doubt, the question's going to be, I'll ask Donnie in a few minutes, will Donnie be in Newry or will he be in the Eglon Springs? Donnie, think carefully before you answer. Right now at the moment, Jerry Murta St. Foyles not worried about dinner dancing all over the country. He's only worried about putting the ball in and putting the ball over the bar, and Roscommon go back to a 3-point advantage, 1-4-4. We spoke of Northern Sound, Donnie, and Carl Craig's goal could be so decisive when this tallies are added up and the final count is in.
Well, I suppose it certainly is. It's like Bill Shankly saying, really, he said that you know, if the opposition score, you have to score 2 to beat them. So, you know, they have to pull it back, haven't they, if they're to win this game. And it's very difficult to pull it back with the way the game is being played.
1-4-4 points. Well won by Carl Giant. Give the ball away. Cavan, 2 good midfielders. Clark and McKiernan. There's only a goal in it. Now, lovely ball by Micheál Lynn, but he gives it away to Niall Daly. Niall Daly, Kieran Cafferty. Weather conditions couldn't be better here this afternoon in Kiltoom. Wonderful setting. And really, the pitch is immaculate condition in Kiltoom this afternoon, as always. And it's going to be a free down for the Cavanmen. 1-4-4. Really good atmosphere this afternoon here in Kiltoom. Long ball got across. Far side of the field. It comes to Micheál Lynn. Micheál Lynn, a teasing ball inside. Looking at the mouse. Wonder will he go for the cheese and get caught in the trap. But the Roscommon defenders there is the trap. And they have kept that piece of mouse secure. And a piece of cheese, rather. And away comes the Roscommon defenders again. 1-4-4 points. Low scoring enough. The goal by Craig. Roscommon full forward line. Jermurta with 3 points. Kieran with one. There's the only Roscommon forwards to score from play, but Sinan Kilbride is having an exceptional game. It's a free in there. Kilbride there winning a free for himself. He takes it very, very quickly. He gives it away, and there's Jarrah McPhishy. I like this cornerback. It's the first time I've seen him play, Damien, but there's something about Jarrah McPhishy. He's like a big terrier. He's snapping away to your heels all the time.
He is, and he's full of pace. Every chance he gets to go forward, he uses his youth and his speed every single opportunity. But Cavan are getting very wasteful with possession of the ball. We're kicking in silly balls, high balls into Martin Dunn against Niall Carty, who he's never going to win that sort of an aerial ball in. We're wasteful on the ball. And
but you're outnumbered inside here, Jamie. The ball is going to be
1-4-4 is how it stands between Roscommon and Cavan. It'll be leading up to half time in just a few minutes' time, and we will head back over right now to Leitrim versus Long. Yes, indeed. Thank you very much for that, John. I believe the score is 1-5-4 points. We'll just join back in with Willie and the lads
at the end of the contest this afternoon.
Yeah, they're just back in now.
Are here in Kiltoom this afternoon. Into Sinan Kilbride. Kilbride there. Will he go for the bite? Oh, no, he's off Kilbride there. Ball has gone inside there, but the Cavan defence have got back and they could secure possession. And they have. That's very, very good play by the Cavan defence there, because young Murta had gone inside. That's great cornerback play there by Jason McLaughlin there. And it's going to be a free out for the Cavan men. 1-5-5. I still didn't see how much time is to be added on at the end of the first half. Just waiting to see how much time will be added on at the end of the first half. So we have a 3-point ball game. Can Cavan now get something to really sink their teeth into it? It'll come to Garrosh McKiernan. Cavan going round the roundabout. Martin Dunn, 3 points from play. A breaking ball. Cavan have it back on the 13-metre line. The pass goes back outside to Riley. Riley can't swing a boot. This man will swing a boot. If he gets an opening, the man that kicked 1 point, he has kicked 2 points. And that is Darragh McPhishy. And he's got 2 in a row. And the man that kicked a lovely, lovely strike of a ball. Lovely balance. And that makes it 1-5-6. And Cathal Shine has now been booked for Roscommon there. Must be something he said to the referee. I think we're back on Northern, our Shannonside listeners. We're about to quit the stoppage time. And in fact, the referee, Michael Duffy, has blown for half time here. The last time the Shannonside listener was with us, it was 1-4-4 points. It's now 1-5-6. Roscommon have got a point by Kieran Murta from a free, 3 scores in a row. But Cavan have come back with an absolutely wonderful point by Martin Dunn from a free. And then the little terrier, Jarrah McPhishy, the cornerback, he's the second top scorer on the Cavan team. Dunn, he's the top scorer from play, Cavan this afternoon. The cornerback, Jarrah McPhishy from Cronulla, he's got a point. He's second of the afternoon, 1-5-6. 6 scores apiece here in Kiltoom. Jamie and Cavan were 4 down. They've got the last 2 scores, which really will give them real belief going in at halftime. Rather than being 4 down, they're now only 2.
Yeah, and on top of that, they've the 4 wides with 2 drops short into the keeper's hands. So I'm guessing, and I'm looking at the field here to our right-hand side, as Donny mentioned earlier, the sun is very much strong behind the goals that Cavan were shooting into that first half. I would think it's a little bit easier shooting down the opposite end of the field. But having said that, then, when you're looking to defend that end too, when you're winning the ball that's coming in, the sun is in your eyes as well. But it's a good response by Cavan. The move to put Mickey Ling inside has worked well enough, because Niall McDermott is starting to get on ball. Unfortunately, there's a couple of silly mistakes happening with Cavan players. Mark McKeever has given away the possession of the ball 3 or 4 times there. Damien Riley was caught. Killian Brady is going to have to be very careful. He's on a yellow card. He was very lucky that he wasn't spotted. You mentioned the foul earlier on that he got away with just after he'd got that yellow card. So he's going to have to be very, very careful, because you can't go giving away a freeze like that when you're on a yellow card and you're a defender. But the two key players, one for each side. Darragh McPhishy's been outstanding for Cavan. Going forward, he's so nimble, he's so quick, he can turn so fast, and he's causing all sorts of trouble for the Roscommon attack. But sending Kilbride inside for Roscommon, absolutely outstanding, hasn't got on the scoreboard, and yet is still probably the best forward out there at the minute, because he's been so instrumental. When he wins possession, he lays it off brilliantly. You know, you look at Roscommon, I make it that they've 4 wides, they've 5 drops short, and they've hit the post once with a free as well. So Roscommon have probably created more chances than Cavan. They'll be looking to maybe convert more chances in the second half.
Johnny, 1-5-6, 6 scores apiece. The general opinion coming into the game from both camps, this will be very, very tight with little between them. It's turning out that way, Johnny. Your thoughts in the first 30 minutes?
Well, I know that John Evans will be certainly concerned at half-time with the Roscommon players giving away possession. The last 3 points Cavan got were given away, possession was given away, lost on the far side of the field, Kieran Capri, last time and down there. They took the wrong options on a number of occasions. Roscommon were 4 or 5 points up. You know, they should be sitting at that. They should be doing like Chelsea were doing last night. Now, they weren't going to lose their point lead, so Roscommon should have done the same thing in the first half. They failed to do that by trying to give running into traffic and that. But in fairness, Cavan punished them, and when Cavan punished them, they deserve a score. You always deserve a score when you're able to turn over the opposition and go down and get a score. You always deserve that score. They worked hard for it. They're working extremely hard, Cavan. But I still think Roscommon are just a little bit physically stronger and have more options to kick in long balls and that type of thing. And I think, as Damien said, Sinan and Fulford, he's the man to be hitting.
And the two Murtas are the only players to score from fame, score points for Roscommon, 3 by Dermot and 2 by Kieran. Cathal Craig with the goal. So Cavan will probably be saying, if we can stop the Murtas, we can win this match.
Well, I would expect Enda Smith up his game in the second half. Enda Smith is one of the better footballers in the far nine, and you know, he hasn't scored yet. There's always a score or two in him, and you know, he can score both goals and points. So I would expect more from Enda Smith in the second half, and certainly Martinelli as well. Martinelli just seems to hold up the ball a little bit too much. He doesn't use the long ball as often as I would like him. I saw on a few occasions he's got a ball under the stand, apparently he came back and Sinan had made a run. You need to be putting that ball into space for a fella like Sinan Gilbride when he's running.
So there we go, that is the halftime score. 1-5 to 6 points for Roscommon versus Cavan and Kiltoom, and we'll be back with the lads in the second half as well. And like John said, the halftime score between Leitrim and Longford is 7 points to 5 points. We'll be back over to John Lynch and the crew in Carrick and Shannon. We'll head over to Kiltoom right now. Roscommon taking on Cavan. At halftime in the Division 2 game, it was Roscommon 1-5, Cavan 6 points. That's how we left it. We'll hand back over to the second half with Willie Hegarty.
We have a 1-5 ball game.
Certainly have, and you know, Roscommon got a very good start in the second half, but Cavan really went at it. But once again, Roscommon had possession there and down on the half-back line, and they lost it again, and they can't be doing that. And certainly, they brought down the ball at midfield as well, for a Cavan man to win it.
Welcome to our Shannon side, listeners. We have a game of ball here now, folks. You probably said you, we know every game ball. Give us a score line. At the moment, it's Roscommon 1-6. It's Cavan 8 points. Enda Smith with a point for Roscommon at the 30 seconds of the restart. Cavan with 2 substitutes. They brought in Joshua Hayes and Barry Riley. And Cavan have started the second half with real urgency. They got 2 tremendous points there by Martin Riley and by Barry Riley and Gareth McKiernan. Roscommon robbed the Cavan men back. It's a really good game of ball here now. In perfect conditions. A crowd of up to 2,000 spectators enjoying the contest right now at the moment. Tight in the corner there now. Ball walked into the centre and Cavan have really renewed vigour at the start of the second half. And here comes Barry Riley. He's launching a Hairy Mary forward. Under the ball is Niall Collins, the man that travelled the world from September to December. But right now he's an Irish side. He's in Kiltoom. He's wearing the primrose and blue jersey. Roscommon have 9. Cavan have 8 in this local derby clash. A long ball gone inside. There could be a second goal chance. It's gone over the bar by Kieran Murtagh. And Murtagh has put over a wonderful point. And that's back to a 2-5 ball game again. It's 1-7 to North 8. Galway are leading Meath 1-6 to 5. Kildare 1-7, down 9 points. Westmeath 1-5, Leash 6 points. So tight in this division. I tell you one thing, really, you'll need the calculators after 4 or 5 games. Roscommon back by a 2-point lead again. 1 goal and 7 to 8 points. 10 points to 8. Also, special mention to Emmett Keane, that's the club Rossi. Roscommon GA mascot this afternoon, who presented the ball out before the game started to the referee Michael Duffy. He's from Elphin. He's Emmett Keane. Keep an eye out for him in the years to come, wearing the Roscommon jersey. He's wearing the new Club Rossi jersey this afternoon. Back it goes to Shawnee McDermott. Also a big day for Club Rossi. They've launched their 215 membership drive this afternoon. A 2-point ball game. We're live in Shannonside Northern Sound to Shawnee McDermott. We've played 6 minutes of the second half. 8 scores apiece. 1-7-8. Everybody now, like a spider to the web, are drawing in this pulsating battle. And Cavan are back there. They're resolute. Damien, we've played 6 minutes second half. And boy, have we gone up in temperatures.
It's a frantic pace out there. They can't possibly live with this pace for the 35 minutes of the second half. But you can see the pace is affecting the quality of the ball going in on both sides, Roscommon and Cavan. There's a lot of interceptions inside the 45 of both teams there, and the quality is just going to have to pick up a little bit. But great ball in there to the Cavan forward line. Grode McCarron on it. What a score.
Absolute. From one end of the field to the other. The ball for Roscommon was sniffed out by the corner back inside there. It came straight down the field, and Gerard McKiernan and Johnny Shine 1-7 to 9. line. Garrosh McKiernan, a big man, he's stamping his authority in this game.
Certainly is, but I keep on repeating myself. We had possession and we give it away down the far side of the field. Bad ball down to Dunton Hearn in the corner, and then they recovered it and he gave a bad ball inside. So, you know, we just have to stop giving away possession.
1-7-9. Alton Harney's on the Roscommon team for Cahill Craig. It's all Cavan at the moment. It's Garrosh McKiernan. He's gone for 3-for-3. McKiernan has kicked him out. Sublime score. If that was Colm Gooch Cooper, if that was Morris Fitzgerald, if that was Peter Canavan, we'd be talking about a dream score. The dominant man, he's becoming the playmaker, he's becoming the leader. 3 shots at goal, the sides are level, it's 1-7-10. What a super score by Garrosh McKiernan. And Roscommon are about to bring in number 21, young Conor Daly, his first start of the year. Jamie, whatever Terry Hyland said at halftime, it should be bottled. It's a different Cavan.
It's unbelievable. And Garrosh McKiernan broke that ball down for himself. Ronan Flanagan picked up the break, handed it back to Garrosh McKiernan. He was on the 20 metre line by 2-3 yards in. Goal chance here for Roscommon though.
Great save by the goalkeeper. It's on the line. It was in the Smith. He pulled in inside there. This was going to happen. It's going to be a free out. That's what could happen in Rome next Saturday. Ireland and Italy in the rugby match. There'll be scrums at the end of the line. And right there, bodies on the line. Everybody throwing their bodies on the line. In the Smith, he twisted, he turned. He was like a kneel. He wriggled his way in along the line there. He pulled the trigger. But the Cavan goalkeeper, Conor Gilsillan, has made a wonderful save. Kieran Caffrey is off to a Scotland team. And number 21, Conor Daly, is in. 10 points apiece. And we have played 44 minutes of the second.
There we go. 44 minutes of the second of the game gone. 1-7-10. It's an action-packed game and an action-packed start to the second half in Kiltoom. It was 9-6 in Carrick and Shannon between Leitrim and Longford when we left you, John Lynch. Yeah, absolutely, John. It certainly is enthralling at this moment in time in both games. When we left the Roscommon game against Cavan, it was Roscommon 1-7, Cavan 10 points, but there has been a few scores in between now and then.
It's going to be a free out there for the Cavan men, but every man is putting his body in the line, putting his toe, putting his fingernail. 1-9-11, a really terrific second half now. 1-7-10 was the last time the Shannon side listeners were with us. Well, folk, you're welcome back here. We have a riveting contest. We have a terrific contest. Roscommon lead by 12-11. Really, both sides are loving playing football now in Division 2. The standard is higher. The anticipation is greater. The crowd are loving it. 2 Murtagh brothers, Kieran O'Dermott, kicked 2 scores when you're away for Roscommon. But folks, I can tell you, Garrosh McKiernan are free in for Roscommon. A foul by Sinan Kilbride, but the star in the second half has been Garrosh McKiernan. 4 outstanding points from play, and Roscommon win another free. Frees are keeping Roscommon alive in the second half. Cavan are kicking the scores from play, and it's frees to only shine. The Murtagh brothers have 4 apiece. They've got 8 points between them. Have the Murtagh brothers this afternoon here, this afternoon. The Murtagh brothers have kicked over 4 points apiece, and it's now 1-9-11 here. An opportunity for Keir of Dermot to get his 5th point. It's a crucial kick. It's 12-11. The clock tells me 16.5 minutes gone in a humdinger here in the sunshine in Kiltoom. Dermot is reliable as Big Ben in London, has kicked it in and kicked the ball over the bar, and Roscommon are back 2 in front. 1-10-11. Roscommon are living on freeze, don't they?
Well, certainly are, but we'll say they haven't had 10 players behind the ball, you get them back very quickly, and they're well drilled to do so. And in doing so, they're putting a lot of pressure onto the Roscommon forward, and they're getting the freeze. Roscommon forward just seem to be getting the freeze.
At the moment, maybe 1 or 2 of them a little bit handy, shall we say. 1-10-11. Cavan have given away 3 frees in the second half. Roscommon have won 5, and Cavan have given away 3 frees. And now the Cavan player, he's been pinned in his own half. He's been robbed by Mark Nelly. There could be a goal chance here. Mark Nelly looking for options. Back to Murtagh, and trigger! It's a 45. Murtagh wins for goal. The Cavan goalkeeper was equal to the task. Conor Gilsillan, the Cavan player, was caught in possession. He was just going down the ground. He couldn't release it. Mark Nelly robbed him. Into German Murtagh. You don't put the bank on Murtagh. You don't put the mortgage on Murtagh. You don't put Nama on Murtagh. And somehow the Cavan goalkeeper was equal to the task. He was like a bank manager. You're getting no money off me today, son. Wonderful save. It's a cracking game, Dave.
It's absolutely brilliant. And Murtagh couldn't have done anything anything more, because it was perfectly placed to the bottom right-hand corner as Murta was facing the goals, and Conor Gilson got down brilliantly, fully outstretched to get it away. But Ronan Flanagan caught in possession there. No need for him to keep going backwards and backwards. There was a lack of options because Cavan are trying to drive forward at this stage, and he got caught out. Goal chance for Roscommon at the time. Well won there by Seth Gilbride.
Quickly taken 45 by Murta to Gilbride. It's one on the trailing ground. Back it goes to Marky Healy. Marky have a pop at goal, out behind the goal, and it's gone wide. And the scoreboard tells me 18 minutes and 15 seconds gone in the second half here in the Allianz National Football League. If we get more updates on the other three games, we will bring them to you. 1:10 to 11. I go back again, Tony, to the goal, the crucial goal.
Well, certainly there's no question about it, and the goal was always going to be, have a big say in the game. But, you know, the game is far from over, and far from over, as I say, but it's given Roscommon just that little cushion.
A little bit of breathing space. The highlight of the second half, we'll get Jamie's thoughts in a couple of moments. Carol McKieran in there, and back goes the Cavan defence again. They're playing exceptionally well.
It's so an enthralling game in Kiltoom, and also an enthralling game in Carrick and Shannon. We really are in for a treat.
There's no other way of describing it. It's 12 points for Leitrim, it's 11 for Longford, one between the teams. We'll give you the opportunity to take a couple of minutes on Kiltoom, and when you come back to us here, we'll call them home.
Absolutely. Thank you very much, John. And it really is enthralling games, both ends today. So we're going to head straight back over. It was 1:10 to 11 points in favour of Roscommon when we left this game.
The pitch is in immaculate condition. There's no real rain. There's nothing. The blue skies. Looks like Roscommon are introducing a couple of subs. Number 26 there, David Murray, is coming on, and we have another sub, and this is a big one, Donny Smith is coming on as well, number 11 there. So a huge impact sub there to be able to bring on. Shows the quality that Roscommon have on the bench. But we're into the final furlong here, 10 minutes to go. Cavan need a score, Roscommon want a score to keep that extra bit of a lead in front of them. It's in the melting pot now, but Cavan really need to get somebody else other than Garrow to lift up this Cavan team at the moment.
Number 26 is coming on. The Cavan team at the moment, the Roscommon team at the moment, looks like David Murray is coming on the Roscommon team at the moment, and going off the Roscommon team, I'll have to wait and see who's Niall Carty is going off. It was an injury he picked. It's an injury he picked up there in that great ball he picked up, and it looks like it could be Kieran Murta. So Kieran Murta is off, Niall Carty is off. I know that coming on the Roscommon team, and that we're at Wednesday, who's coming on the Roscommon? David Murray's on for Niall Carty. One party, and Donny Smith is on. Not you, we're back on Shannon's side, not yet. 1:10 to 11. We have a 2-point ball game, and we have 10 minutes to play. And here come Cavan. Cavan have 6 wides. Roscommon have 6 wides. 11 scores apiece. There isn't a call between them. Here's Killian Clark. We're back on Shannon's side, Northern Sound. 1:10 to 11. The last time you joined us, it was 1:10 to 11. We only had one other scorer. It's gone in. It's gone wide for Cavan. I don't think we've no score since. No score, Dara, since you left us here. We have a famine, but we have an enthralling contest, and we have 9 minutes to play. Fasten the seatbelt for this landing. Roscommon and Cavan, Allianz National Football League Division 2. Galway 2 up on Meath. Kildare 1 up and down. Westmead 1 up on Leash. 4 games, only a point and a half difference between the 4 teams in the Allianz National Football League on opening Sunday. Division 2 is going to be cutthroat. And that's why this game this afternoon is really going to be so important. No score since you left us last. Cavan and Roscommon, they're battling for everything. And that a free in for day. It looks like the Roscommon men. Roscommon have brought on Ulton Hanley at half time. They brought on Conor Daly. They brought on David Murray for Niall Carty. He's gone off injured. And Tony Smith, he has come in for Kieran Murta. Kieran Murta has scored 5. Kieran has scored 4. Carl Craig the goal. In the Smith the point. 1:10 to 11. A break in play, Johnny. Give our listeners a feel of what we've witnessed for the first 28 minutes of a pulsating second half.
Well, certainly, there's no question about it. It's a super second half. You wouldn't take your eye off it. I think Niall Carty is a huge loss. No disrespect to David Murray, but he's an absolute huge loss because, he's such an experienced player and he plays so well all the time. But I have to say, Martinelli on that occasion put his life on the ground to win that ball, and in doing so he picked up an injury, and he did very well, it gave Roscommon possession back, and the longer Roscommon had possession, the better chance they have of winning it.
A goal in Pier Stadium for Galway. Galway 2-12, Meath 10 points. There is one for the Union Basket, and there is the one for the league table tonight. Galway looks like they're going to be top of the table. And Roscommon on the attack. They lead, lovely flowing football. Cavan and their play was held up, and away come the Cavanmen again. We've got a long time, I haven't.
So 1-10 to 11 point. It is a long time, like William is saying there, between the last score. We'll head back over to Carrick and Shannon now. Leitrim.
So Leitrim 1-12 for Longford. Back to you, Dara.
Thank you very much, John. I do believe there's been plenty of action in the game between Roscommon and Cavan. Since we left them, it was 1-10 to 11 points last we left, but I think it's now Roscommon 1-11 and Cavan 13.
Martin Riley, we have a minute to play. 1-11 to 14 points. Will Roscommon take a draw? Will Cavan take a draw?
I will now, Willie.
Jordy, would you take a draw?
Well, I think so at the minute, but we will. And you know, Roscommon have gone for a short kick out, which isn't a simple right thing to do, in my opinion.
We've 1 minute to play. Can Roscommon get the winner? Can Cavan hold on? Could Cavan rob Roscommon to get the winner? Or will we have a draw? The two promotion sides. Will the finish level? It comes to Mark Healy. Mark Healy, one last throw of the dice to Niall Collins. The Collins down to the right man, Murta. But back goes Speedy Gonzalez. Back goes Josh Hayes. But Murta has it. He's pinned in the corner. Like the farmer with the beast heading for the crush. Right now at the moment, we're into stoppage time. We've 30 seconds to play. The sides are level. An absolute cracker, as Frank Carson would say. The breaking ball.
Cavan
have a turnover. And Cavan have a free. And we've 30 seconds to play. Is there time? Referee Michael Duffy looks at his watch.
Most important thing now is that Cavan don't give away possession. When they have the ball, they can get the score. It's with Killian Clark now in the middle of the field.
A free down for Cavan. 10 seconds to play. 14 points apiece. Roscommon and Cavan. Darryl McPherson is this side of the defeat free at the moment. I think it's all be a fair result. That'll be my call on it. Everybody could go home happy. The two promotion teams. Michael Duffy, I think he's going to blow full time. Is he? He's not yet. Cavan have won the last chance. It's all over.
It's
a draw game. It's 1-11 to 14 points. How important will that point be at the end of the last round of league matches? A point apiece for the two promotion sides. 1-11 to 14 points. Handshakes by Terry Hyland and John Evans. I'm going to let these two boys debate 70 wonderful minutes. All I can say is that it was a privilege and a delight to be here in Kiltoom this afternoon for two sides that left everything on the field of play. 1-11 to 14 points. Damien and Johnny, it's over to you for the next couple of minutes. Johnny at the home side this afternoon. 1-11 to 14 points. Give us your verdict.
Well, certainly Roscommon, I'd say, are happy now with the draw, but you know, it's one Roscommon should have been winning. Cavan have got the bonus point today. There's no question about it. They deserved it. We couldn't take it away. Lucky not to take two out of here. Roscommon are lucky they didn't take two out of here. But I'm sure Roscommon, I have to be critical of the amount of possession Roscommon gave away. And I would love to see the video and go back and count how many possessions they gave away. But having said that, they took they got the equaliser, they went ahead again. They did everything right for a lot of the time, but apart from them few blips. But Cavan will go away very happy, and Roscommon will go away happy enough.
Just to interlude there for a moment, a massive win for Down 3-13, Kildare 1-15. Massive win for Down, a draw game here. Damien, you've drawn your breath. Galway have beaten Mead, we know that well. So great win for Down, great win for Galway at the moment. But Damien, what an absolute cracker we had here. 1-11 to 14 points. A privilege. What a second half.
It was unbelievable entertainment. Like, there was a long spell in the second half where there was no scores, but the intensity in the game, the speed of the tackle, in fairness to both teams, I have to commend them, because when they turned over possession, they were trying to get it forwards. Right, granted, sometimes the quality wasn't great, they were misplacing balls, but they were trying to play attacking football when they were in possession of the ball, and it made for end-to-end stuff. Like, it to me, it was an absolutely wonderful second half. Cavan, I think Donny hit it right there. Although a draw is probably a fair result, Cavan will be the happier of the two teams, considering the fact the home games are going to be so important. Only three home games for Roscommon, so to get a point on the road against a very good Roscommon team, Cavan will probably be delighted with it. And at half time they'd have taken it, considering they were down by that all important goal. But it was an absolutely outstanding game. Second half performance by Garrod McKernan really dragged Cavan back into the game. The three points in a row early in the second half. When Cavan were down, it was 1-6, 1-6 to 7 points. Grode McKernan hit 3 in a row, which were vital. Cavan gave away the 2 silly frees that brought Roscommon back into the game when really Cavan were dominating. But I tell you, You were saying earlier on, Willie, that, you know, the loser of this game might be looking down and the winner could be, you know, happy to stay up. There's no reason I don't see why these two teams can't go on and try and push for promotion, because Division 2, we've seen Monaghan come out of Division 3 last year and go straight up and win Division 2 again. It showed that Division 3 isn't that bad, and Cavan and Roscommon were both clearly the most dominant teams in Division 3 last year. So they've a young age profile, they're in a perfect position to go and try and push for promotion now, both sides.
Cavan won the second half, 8 points to 6.
Yes, well, Roscommon did fail to convert a few 45s and a few things like that, and that type of thing. They need to brush up in the end of things, and, you know, they just need to keep their position a little bit better. They allowed Senan Kilbride to be fluffed out of the game in the second half. Fair dues to Cavan for doing that, but Roscommon didn't get the ball in quick enough into them, and Cavan was watching the way they tracked back extremely well. Maybe that's the reason they give away the few frees, because there were so many tackles coming in at the one time on players going in. But having said all that, you know, we have to go away here and say, look, it was a great game of football. If it was being played again tomorrow night, it'd be here. There's no question about that. Great game of football. As I say, Cavan will be the happier of the two, but Roscommon will be happy they didn't lose it.
One player for me, and they've got a huge introduction, was Barry Riley.
Yeah, absolutely outstanding. And he done what we all know Barry is capable of doing. When he gets ball, he's very incisive with his passing from out the field, and he can kick a point, as he did when he came on, a wonderful point from distance. But Barry brings something different to the Cavan team that we don't have a lot of players that use the kick pass from the middle toward of the field, and he's one player that was a big loss last year. True work, he couldn't be available for the Cavan panel, but him coming back in now, and the more game time he gets, the better he's going to be. So it was outstanding. Darren McFeedy, 2 points, you know, it deserves honourable mention, because, you know, he's so nimble, he's so quick on the ball, and he's elusive. You know, you look at him and you don't think this lad's going to cause much threat, but he's all the time on the ball and a great option. But it was, you know, the two Mortas inside for Roscommon. Enda Smith came into it in the second half as well, I have to say. The forward quality, you probably have to maybe question the amount of missed opportunities, as Donny said, because with forwards of that quality, you've nearly come to expect them that they don't miss as many as they did today.
Cavan only led the very first minute of the game.
Yeah, it was outstanding. Like, 1-1, 1-0 to nil was the only time the Cavan led, and then they got back level with, what, 2 minutes left on play. So it was probably a fair result in the balance of it in the end. But, you know, Roscommon would probably look at it, a home game, leading for probably 60 minutes out of the 70, maybe 65 minutes out of the 70. They will be disappointed that they didn't just seal it out. Maybe a little bit cuter in defence might have just snuffed out that game. But look, it's a learning curve.
Finally, Johnny, the positive for Roscommon, new life in Division 2. It's, you know, it's a new landscape, it's a different ball game. The positive, Johnny.
Certainly, yeah, there's a lot of positives in it. And of course, I suppose the loss of Cathal Craig and Nigel Carty were a big loss. And, you know, we hope that Ulton Herney came in after playing 45 minutes of a game yesterday evening, and, you know, he wouldn't be expected to be at the top, but did extremely well. And you know, Roscommon will have to go back, and when they look at the videos of this match, and I certainly will expect that they will cry at the amount of possession they give away at crucial times. And if they followed on from that, they'll look at the amount of times that Cavan punished them, and you have to take their hats off to Cavan. They scored about 7 of the finest points that I've seen scored in the second half, from out around the 45 metre range. Never looked at the goal, picked them straight over the bar. Derek Kieran, Barry Riley, and, you know, Martin Riley, they got some superb points in the second half, and deserved their point.
And finally, Damien, I suppose from an outsider looking in, Terry Hyland, the Cavan team, have probably taken a lot of hard hits, criticism about their style of football, but certainly in the second 35 minutes of the afternoon, you know, whether it's Lee McHale or suddenly the juice, the kick pass, but certainly going forward as a unit, Cavan looked very good.
Yeah, like, it was clearly evident throughout the McKenna Cup that Cavan's style of football has changed with the introduction of maybe new management, or probably the realisation that last year it just wasn't good enough to get us that step forward. So you can see that there's a lot more speed in the attack. They're trying to use that kick pass. Possibly we could do it a big man in the full forward. But when Michael Argue gets back from injury there, he might give you that option that you can allow to put maybe even Garrod McKiernan in for 10 or 15 minutes in that full forward line. But we need that big target man so that we can deliver the early ball. The way Sending and Bright was winning in the first half, we need a Sending and Bright or somebody of that calibre. It's just good to see that the style of football, the attacking part of Cavan's game, has vastly improved on last year, which can only be positive going forward.
The big news from here, the two promoted sides are still unbeaten in the Ireland National Football League. Cavan head to Portlaoise next Sunday to play Laois, and Roscommon next Saturday night are against the big winners of the Ireland National Football League
division. We're Saturday night as well.
Oh, you're Saturday night as well.
Yes.
The Porto was our Saturday night fever underlined.
It couldn't be better.
You're in Portlaoise and we're in Park Ishla in Newry, who beat Kildare 3-13 to 1-12 today. That will send a shiver down the spines of Roscommon when they head to play down next Saturday night. A point apiece here. What a start to the Ireland National Football League. All I can say is that if the next six games are like this game, finally, the next six games, Damien, are like this one, you know, we are in for some treat and some roller coaster.
We sure are. I'll tell you what, I'm looking forward to next week already, because the pace, the standard, there was no moment for hiding. There was no moment to take a breath in that game. And Division 2 has already got off to a great start, Willie.
I hope the folks at home enjoyed our coverage this afternoon. McManus Pharmacy was the sponsor this afternoon. We thank them very much. Cavan, 14 points. Roscommon, 111. 32 the draw yesterday. I'm not too sure there's anybody at home at the moment having a slice of cake and a cup of tea and saying, I backed the draw at 13-2. No, I didn't. Did anybody back it? Great contest. Roscommon and Cavan have finished level. It's Boy from Kiltoom.
Thank you very much to Willie and to Damien and to Donny and all the crew down there today. An excellent game, 111-14. And left a note at your bedside. I'm far too shy to speak to you at school. You leave me numb and I'm not sure.
Someone we're happy anyway, we've got a point. That's the first thing. And whether it is a point shared or a point left behind, that's for the analysts afterwards. But certainly, I suppose, an opportunity as we had with a few gift-edged opportunities there that we certainly left after us. And we should have. But look, it's the first round of the league. Maybe there was a lot of pressure being at home, and the game as a spectacle, it was just horrible. It was just up and down the field, block, and. Sure, at some stage, that type of work, we should have put them away, I suppose, earlier on, and we left them back in. And when you leave any team there lying there with an opportunity, I think you sort of, it comes back to haunt you.
That's John Evans, happy enough with the draw, as was Cavan manager Terry Hyland.
Well, we're happy to get a draw, but it was hard fought all through for us. I suppose every time we got a bank level, especially in the second half, just common seemed to just kick a point at whoever. So from that point of view, we're happy to come out with a point out of it already.
What a day too for Garrod McKiernan. He scored some great points.
He did, and he's a very, very good footballer. He tied a little bit at the end there, but then in final, there's no doubt that he was the catalyst for us getting back in the game in the second half.
Did you pick up any injuries out there today? Because there was a lot of knocks and bruises.
Well, I'm sure, as it'd be so, we picked up nothing obvious. Again, tired legs, I suppose, and it is only the first week in February, so you know what I mean? There's a lot of heavy training being done, so I thought pitching conditions was quite good out there, so it possibly wasn't a bad game for a spectator to watch.
Please take your time, I'm not in any rush. And it's in everything I ever write.
The first thing that it hit you is that, you know, that you're up in the grade, is that the fight for the points going to be huge in every game, because not only on the day that you play, but I think, you know, how you respond to maybe defeat, or how you respond to victory is going to be crucial, because once the games are coming up on top of each other, if you're not playing to your full maximum, you're going to be chasing this league. But in saying that, looking at the table this week, we're halfway up the table, we have a point. There's a couple of teams that won't have points Saturday evening or at the end of Sunday evening, so we just feel that maybe it was a game that we probably could have won if we had taken enough chances. You know, it was a game that Cavan, I suppose, were entitled to a point with the way they played as well. So, you know, in one sense you're feeling that was a point lost, but at the same time, you know, we haven't lost in our first match in Division 2, which is crucial.
Yeah, it's absolutely brilliant to have something on the board heading up to Park Estler. Just going back briefly, Gay, on the Cavan match, and it's interesting to see maybe some of the reaction during the week to the game. And one of the things being mentioned is maybe that Roscommon were going for goals, perhaps when there was opportunities of taking points on. Now, you could maybe feel why they could have been doing that. They scored four goals in the FBD final a week previously against Galway, and a lot of plaudits were being landed on their shoulders as regards the build-up play to those particular goals. So that little bit of experience will probably come maybe when to go for a goal and when to take a point.
Well, I think that's a crucial phase of, you know, I mean, a couple of weeks ago, maybe, we had been looking at the way that we were playing, and we felt they weren't making any goal chances. And then, you know, against Cavan, we made three good goal chances in the second half. Against Galway, we made four or five. Against Mayo, we made three or four, took two. Against NUIG, we made a good few goal chances, but we weren't putting them away. And against IT Sligo, we didn't make any goal chances. So we have been making the chances, which is a sign that our play is improving, that we're getting into the right places. But, you know, I suppose young lads, you know, when they're playing like that, they see the goal chance, they're told, take the goal chance if the goal is on. If the goalkeeper makes a save, well, then everyone says they should have taken the point. So we are making the chances. We're getting the ball into that area where we feel that we can put it away. And against Galway, we did put away. There's no argument about it. But against Cavan, we had a couple of chances. And, you know, as the game turned out, and it was only as the game turned out, we found that if we had tapped the ball over the bar, walked out, faced the kick out, maybe get another score, that maybe we might have got a goal in the second half. But, you know, hindsight is brilliant. And hindsight will make somebody a lot of money sometime.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it. It's 2020 vision. Well, one thing we know for certain is that on Saturday now, it's a trip to Park Estler and Newry to take on Down. The league, I'd be maybe a little bit reluctant to maybe go too much by looking ahead week per week, because there's going to be an awful lot of changes. A team that wins one week inevitably could find themselves coming back down to earth the following week. However, having said that, Down's tails are up now in the sense that they had a big victory against Kildare last weekend up in Newbridge, a game where they played second fiddle to Kildare for long spells, but eventually came good at the end to win the match. So at the same time, they'll take a lot of confidence, they'll have momentum maybe from that, but when you look at the overall picture, it's fair to say as well that Kildare caused them problems.
Well, it is. I mean, Kildare scored 114 or 115 in the game, which is a big score for the winter. They did miss a penalty also, which probably would have put the game out of Down's reach. In saying that, Down scored 313, which is a mighty score in the first round of the league. And, you know, I mean, if we go back to Kildare and Mayo last year when they played in the first round of the league, it was 314 to 213 or something like that. It was a very, very high score. And Kildare, at both ends of the spectrum, they can score at one end and they concede at the other. Now, Down kept plugging away and they were able to get the scores in the end. And that will tell you one thing about Down, especially with new management coming in. You know, there's going to be a huge amount of self-belief in them after taking the 2 points from that game. But I just think that this game against Down will suit us, because both teams, I think the style of play are fairly similar. You know, both teams have a lot of good footballers that like to play ball. And I just feel that it's going to be an end-to-end game up and down the field. And, you know, when it comes down, in the end, it's going to come down to the shootout. And whoever defends best is going to have that edge. And I just feel, you know, that we have the firepower there. We are making the chances and we just have to put them away. Our defence, you know, just the full back line has been playing extremely well. And, we're going to tighten up around the middle of the field and that, and make sure that they don't get a run on us. And, you know, it's just a game that we're just looking forward to now, big time.
Yeah, it's going to be a real test for Roscommon. And I'm interested as well there, Gay, in the sense that you picked out midfield, because Garoge McKiernan, there's no doubt about it, from all reports, had a major influence in Cavan's revival in the second half. Roscommon have had their injuries in that particular sector of the field as well. So, again, it's probably an area that you've already alluded to there that you'll want to work on. Is there concerns there, or would it maybe even be enough to suggest perhaps changing of a game plan maybe to counteract that?
Well, you know, there's an old saying, you never know the value of a bush until it's cut. And I think, you know, with Kevin Higgins gone from our midfield, it has been a huge change for us, because, you know, the amount of work that Kevin Higgins had been doing in the middle of the field for Roscommon over the last 3 years. People weren't recognising it because they'd look at him going up the field, he scored 3 points and he might have 6 shots. But the amount of work that he'd done, linking defence and attack and winning dirty ball in midfield and keeping going all through, he had an engine that is unbelievable. And he's missing out at the engine room, and you can see that. And it's very, very hard to replace the likes of Kevin Higgins with 4 or 5 years' experience in the middle of the field. Cathal Shine is in there, and he's still only young as well. And then you have, you know, Mark Healy is in there. Mark Healy's only after coming out of under 21. So, you know, we're going to have to adopt our role around the middle of the field, that middle third, that we are going to strengthen it there by maybe stick an extra body in it or whatever. But a lot of the time, you know, when you put in a couple of different combinations, it's only then that you will find out what you can work with. And, you know, we're going to have to keep trying combinations until we get something permanent there, or Kevin Higgins gets back in and then he stakes a claim back in there again. But it is an area, you know, when you have a midfielder scoring 4 points from play and maybe a half-back's coming up and kicking points from that area there as well, well, then you have to see that you're in a bit of trouble there, and you have to start, you know, getting a little bit of remedial action inside there. And that's what we're going to have to do on Saturday evening. But in saying that, McKiernan is a good midfielder, and he does kick some good scores. He'd done the same against us in the league final in Croke Park. He still kicked the 3 points on play, and he will do it against any team. So it's our intention to tighten up in that spot there. And I think anybody that's playing there knows themselves that they can't allow that to happen again.